makes me really going like, I can't play the main game if I can't get through the demo. Because
okay,
supposedly that's what the entire demo was for on PC, was to see if people could actually play it.
Okay, we're live now, by the way.
Yeah.
Okay. This is how we're going to start things off.
Boss. There's
with Subaru Foresters?
No. This is how desperate I am now. We're going to watch this video.
I like how the video is right there now.
We're going to watch the goddamn video. I'm going to find out how the fuck I'm going to beat Radon.
Out of the Earth Tree video, we're going to be going over a full guide on how to beat Radon, Concert of Mikola. This is definitely the
Because I know I can do that, but I'm not going to I'm not going to go that far. I'm not going to do the shield poke win, because that would be the way to win, and I'm not going to do that.
I've ever fought out of every Souls-like they've done in the past 15 years. He has fast movesets, insane AoEs, and even an almost impossible to dodge attack. It goes without saying that you should not ignore leveling your Scouter Tree fragments all the way to 20 if you have to, as this is
the
boss
20.
In the DLC.
Maybe that's the first thing I should do.
This boss is fighting as close
I don't know if it matters though.
For the entire fight, as it's basically mandatory to dodge his AoEs in phase 2, and is useful for getting extra damage in between some of his combos from both phases. If you've completed the Thiolier questline, you should be able to summon both him and Anspach for this fight. But keep in mind that Radon's HP will scale super high if you summon both at the same time.
Oh, so summoning both at the same time is a bad idea. Got it.
For physical negation, find Crucible Feather Talisman for a special backstep on the impossible to dodge attack, and Golden Braid for Holy Negation. To start off, when you enter the arena, he's almost always going to do this rush attack that stops you from using summons or buffing up after you enter. So keep in mind, if you're buffing up, try to do it before you enter, and if you're trying to summon, try to do it after you dodge his attack. You can dodge this initial attack by dodging into it at the last second, and then you can get about a heavy attack of damage in afterwards. His basic and most common combo is the following. A right foot stomp into an overhead sword slash, into a quick
right
double sword
stomp.
Sweep, into an overhead sword slash, and then a ground explosion. He uses this move a bunch throughout the fight, so it's definitely worth learning the timing. Dodge after a delay when he does the right foot stomp, then after another delay, dodge twice in quick succession, then dodge two more times, both with a delay for the overhead and the ground explosion. You should kind of be dodging into Radon for all of these, with a slight deviation to the left or right. It's worth noting that after you roll that quick double attack, there is actually a small opening for exactly one light attack with most weapons, so try to get that damage in if you can. He has one other super long combo. We'll start with a right
I'm watching
sweep,
this just to help me remember his moveset, because otherwise we already have his first base peg,
and then one more delayed attack. For this combo, roll the first attack, then dodge after a very slight delay for the left sword sweep, then delay your next three dodges for his three double sweep attacks. Again, there is an opening between the 4th and 5th hit for exactly one light attack, where you can get some damage in. And after dodging it all, you can get one heavy attack in. Sometimes he won't do that final delayed attack, so keep that in mind when you're dodging this. Those two combos are his bread and butter, but he has a few other difficult moves as well. To start, let's go over the infamous cross-slash attack. When you heal at the wrong time or attack too late, Radon will often use this move where he attacks two times in succession with his blades, then do a final cross-slash. This attack is actually basically impossible to dodge when you have no added gimmicks, requiring frame-perfect timing and altitude positioning to avoid it. That being said, after doing some testing, there are a few ways to counter it. You could dodge it normally with frame-perfect timing, block it with a shield, parry it, or use the fine Crucible Feather Talisman to get iframes on backsteps, and dodge it with an early backstep into a quick dodge and then a delayed roll. If you didn't parry, after he finishes the combo, you can get a heavy attack in. I definitely think this is going to get nerfed in the foreseeable future.
And he
now,
told, and it was totally nerfed, so this guy knows what he's talking about.
Another three-hit combo with his sword starts with an overhead right swing, then after a slight delay, he does two sweeps in quick succession. If you dodge this, you can only get one light attack in before his next move. One more super short two-hit combo is his right sweep into a double sword left sweep. Despite this attack being relatively easy to dodge compared to others, it has a massive window where you can land a heavy attack if you dodge this correctly. Next, he has something kind of like a grab move. He'll slowly lift his swords up, slash them upwards, then after delay, slash them back down.
Oh no, not this move. That was the gravity one.
First attack, you get launched into the air.
I hate this move. Not this move.
So learn the timing for this one, and don't forget to dodge the second hit after dodging the first. When the boss is far away from you, sometimes he'll do a jumping attack. For this attack, he'll jump up and do a roll in the air, then crash down with both of his swords. He has a chance to jump again, and then do one more jumping attack. Either way, if you correctly dodge this, you can get one heavy attack in afterwards. If you find yourself having trouble with his random second attack, just do one light attack after his first, as that will give you some time to roll if he does the second move. Next up, he also has a Blood Flame attack. This attack is actually very easy to avoid once you know the trick to dodging it. First, dodge the initial thrust by dodging into him, and then sprint behind him to get one light attack in. By going behind him, you avoid both his slash attack and the aftershock explosion, and can even get one light attack in.
I'm not too worried about that one. That one rarely hit
him, as the explosion will hit you if you're on his side. Lastly, for the basic moves, he has a retreating attack where he does a cross slash.
Stealing gotcha luck.
Most of the time, it's safe to do a light attack right after, but I've had a few occasions where I got.
I'm not rolling any gotchas for at least another week, so you're not stealing anything.
Just wait after you dodge.
That's
moving
the
on to the gravity
idea.
Moves, let's see his gravity meteor move. This attack actually has.
Also, if they get a bad roll, I'm blaming you, Eddie.
First, when he slashes his
sword. Don't steal from me.
Then, when he slashes upwards and rises. And lastly, the ranged meteors.
Okay. Only two SRs?
Dodge twice in quick succession to dodge.
No, I'm blaming this on Eddie because I only got two SRs.
The meteors run away in the opposite direction until the meteors get close, then run to the left or right and then jump.
Okay, so I can jump out of that. That's good to know. Oh, I hit that one.
Grab move or a special gravity move.
Yeah,
you can roll the initial pull by dodging with the timing, but if you do get pulled, it's actually pretty easy to avoid damage. You can just spam roll away from him to dodge either the gravity AoE or the grab attack. In the second phase though, you definitely want to dodge that initial pull as the following attacks are really difficult to dodge. Moving on to phase 2, he'll start this phase
here
with 60% health, cleansing him of any status
Gold flash.
And stopping all attacks with a cutscene. For this phase, all of his attacks will summon an AoE of Holy Beams in front of Radahn, and he gets a bunch of absolutely disgusting combos that will knock just about anyone into the 14th dimension the first time they see it.
90%
of the time, the first thing he'll do is summon a giant AoE of holy damage.
Before he fuck does off, Aran!
Time to drink about one flask, and then you'll have to run as soon as you see him charging it. This attack has a very unforgiving window if you have even the slightest delay, so make sure you run in a straight line as fast as you can.
There's a run toward him.
With something like Raptor of the Mists, or block it with a good holy negating shield like the Blacksteel Great Shield. In this phase, his attacks from phase 1 haven't actually changed too much. His bread and butter combos have the exact same timing, just with beams in front of Radahn. Dodge slightly into him for every attack like I mentioned in phase 1, and you shouldn't be hit by a single thing. This also applies for the huge holy AoE that replaces his ground explosion. Just roll into it and you won't take any damage. He also gets one new combo that has the exact same timing as the stomp attack, except it starts with an overhead right swing, and I thought I'd mention that here. The Blood Flame attack is the exact same with no change, and the Impossible Cross Slash attack is avoided basically the same way for every method. For the jumping attack, all you need to do is dodge to the left or right to avoid the straight line of beams.
Dodge
you also do the
right.
same
Got
thing
it.
For the quote-unquote grab attack from phase 1. Any other basic move from his phase 1 can just be dodged into. The only attack from phase 1 that is considerably harder to dodge is his meteor attack. The first part of this attack is the same. Avoid the first two hits, then run away from the meteors and jump right or left at the last moment. However, after that, he has additional attacks. He'll do four after image attacks before teleporting onto you for a fifth slash, summon a straight line of beams,
that's
and then
so
finally
sick.
Does
I hate
a massive
that.
Holy AoE. To avoid this, run away after jumping the meteors to get out of range of the four
after jump out of the meteors.
Then dodge into
then
him, veering to the left or right.
One,
first
two,
slash,
three,
to avoid that
four,
AoEs
dodge the fifth.
After the slash.
And dodge
and after
the
a short
AoE.
Delay, dodge into him again for the big AoE. Moving on, let's go into his new basic moves of phase 2. He has a full arena holy AoE where he raises both swords and slashes them forwards. Dodge into this with good timing and it shouldn't hit you. He now has an actual grab attack that will insta-kill you if it hits you twice, but it can be dispelled using Mikola's rune. He also has a new dash attack where he starts glowing and dashes with after images to a set location. If you're close to him, you can literally just stand inside of him and not take
really?
Any damage.
Oh, okay.
He also has another dash attack that he sometimes uses when he's far away. He'll dash sideways, throw an after image at you, and then throw a slash attack at you. Just dodge into him twice, and you should be able to avoid damage. You get the opening for about one light attack. He also has this new ranged attack where he'll hurl a holy discus at you, then do one slash after a short delay. You should try to get close after dodging this attack, as he has a window for a whole heavy attack after he finishes the combo. Lastly, he'll do a meteor attack at around 40% health. For this one, run in the opposite direction as soon as you can, and keep running until you can see the explosion reach your character. To finish this guide off, lastly but most importantly, we have his new special combos. The first one is where he jumps into the air, does 3 after image attacks, then lands on top of you and does one of his combos. For this attack, the best way to avoid it is to run to the right, dodge the 4th attack, then dodge twice after a short delay for his basic combo. You can also roll into the after
images, such bullshit.
But it's really inconsistent, so I don't recommend it. The next one is much more tricky, with a bunch of flashbangs in between his hits. Verdun's swords will start glowing, he'll raise them up in a pattern, then do the following. 2 quick sweeps, 2 more quick sweeps,
in the meantime, I'm
attack,
gonna mute myself and I'll be right back.
With a 360 AoE explosion. Mm-hmm. For this one, you want to dodge the first 2 quick sweeps with 2 quick rolls. Then after quick a delay, rolls. Dodge only once for the other 2 quick sweeps, dodge again after delay for the jumping attack, and then dodge one last time for the falling attack. All you can really do for this is learn the timing, but you can also block it with the shield. And with that, that is every single attack in Radahn's moveset explained. In summary, you want to dodge into him for basically every single attack, run away from the afterimage attacks, and try using everything in your disposal to challenge this boss. There is absolutely no shame in using a Mimic tier, as this is definitely the hardest boss From Software has ever put out.
I don't know how I feel about that. That it made me feel a little bit better, but I'm not sure how much better. But yeah, I know this fight. Let's hit the phase 2 already. Okay. Run right toward him. Avoid that AoE. Dodge into his attacks. Dodge the grab. There's the blood flame thing again. Oh, that was hard to read. Dodge, 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 dodge. You jump out of the way of the rocks, then run towards the screen. It looks insane. I'm not even playing, I can barely keep up.
I mean, it is a pretty difficult fight because, let's face it, usually when From Software is designing bosses, big bosses are slow, small bosses are fast. Radahn is sort of both.
He's a big man, but he's also a small man.
Well, he's big and fast. I mean, he has some slow attacks, but then he has some fast attacks.
1, 2, 3, 4, dodge! Dodge!
Actually, does his after image attack have fake outs? Like, it only does it 3 times versus 4?
I'm not sure.
That's gonna suck trying to dodge that. Okay. All right. Let's do this for real.
Bite the bullet, Eddie. Bite it hard.
Come on, believe in yourself, because nobody else here is believing in you.
Don't believe in me. Don't believe in yourself, Eddie. Don't believe in me, because I'm not going to believe in you.
There's an update. Guys, we can't play today. There's an update. Sorry.
Why did you not do the update?
Because he hasn't played the game in 2.5 weeks.
think it's been 3 weeks, actually.
Close to.
I thought you did it on Thursday on the last week.
No, because I was gone for 2 weeks.
No, obviously the last 2 weeks. Obviously, you missed on this week's Tuesday, but I mean 3 weeks ago. Well, yeah, you played it on last Thursday.
The last time I played was the 12th of September.
Okay. Yeah, that's exactly 3 weeks. Okay. And especially since you didn't even start at like 7.
Let's get this party started.
Are you starting up the game or are you updating?
I guess it'll be the intro video. Starting the game. I'm about to share it here in a bit.
Ask Bram. Or Shorbert.
Nope. I shared too early. I think I shared it too early. What's going on? Why aren't you playing?
Right now?
I think that's the problem.
It's booting up. It's initializing. We'll see. I'm not initialized already. Okay, I think it finally got past its misgiving. Come on. There we go. Now I can share it with you.
Bando Namkai.
Ring of the Elden.
On connection.
Let's do this.
Oh, wow. That makes me feel old.
What?
Well, I'm just going through some anime just to go through my mind of like, what could I possibly recommend that isn't terrible? Horrible. Undignified.
Berserk 2014.
No. Wait, 2014, are we talking about the movies?
I'm talking about the movies, yes.
Okay. Dude, my frame rate is bad.
Well, supposedly the movies eventually started getting good, but then they made a series, and then that was bad. Is everything okay?
Nope.
Frame rate bad.
Yeah, this game is jumpy as hell.
Yep.
Is something else running in the background?
Oh, no, it just gave up. Maybe that was something to do with it. Okay. I lost connection to the game. The game disconnected from me for some reason.
Disconnected, can't run an offline?
Yeah. Technical difficulty. Come on. It's trying again now. I'm going to get into the game before I share. Let's see how things are running. Okay, no longer choppy. Okay, let's go ahead and share. Because sharing is caring. Okay, I think we're good now.
Ooh, that's a good question. Have you watched Thunderbolt Fantasy?
I have not.
Oh, okay.
That is...
I know, but...
Technically not anime, but...
Also not. I don't think he would mind much.
Probably not.
Yeesh, even that's getting almost old. They came out in spring 2016.
Ugh. And we're just getting, what, season 3? Or season 4?
Alright, because I thought...
What? I just lost connection again.
How much? It's not us, I would think.
Outer? And it will start in online mode.
Could this be part of the weird...
I guess it doesn't matter. So...
Rude.
That's kind of rude. Admittedly, this is something I've been hearing a lot lately, is a lot of games and online service games have been experiencing, like, DDoS stuff, including 14. I haven't experienced it myself, but then again, I'm not going to deny somebody from going, like, I can't sign in, or I get kicked off immediately.
Come on, let's do it. Let's do it. Come on. I'm dead. Yep, I gotta get the rust off. It's been 3 weeks.
That's a lot of rust.
Yes, you're telling me.
Have we ever summoned somebody for this battle yet?
Yes, yeah. And it went poorly.
Oh. Oh, yeah, now I remember.
Let's try the jumping out of the way thing. I didn't roll out of the rocks. God damn. God, he's scarier than I remember, and that's saying something. Thank you. Crap! Fell for it! What? Damn it! Hit that stump!
Stump.
And considering that before we went off, I was acing that first phase, I really have
roosted.
Yeah, I have digressed. Degressed? Whatever.
Regressed, I believe.
Regressed. Thank you very much. Did it miss? God damn. Sure, why not? Just take the hit. Shit. How do you miss? He's right in front of you! Let's see if I can learn anything from that video. No, no, absolutely did not learn anything.
A 1,000-year voyage guided by compassion.
This is going to be a 1,000-year voyage.
That's right. You still haven't gotten hit by the second time.
Yep.
Probably because of that.
I wasn't close enough. Apparently, if I just stand next to him, it won't hit me.
Well, it's easier to sidestep than it is to run away from.
Oh, I forgot my count.
Okay, we're at 98 kills. I would like not to get hit, please.
Stop hitting me. Please.
Fucking footstone. If I'm lucky, I'll go Mob Psycho. And at 100, I'm gonna win.
Question mark, question mark, question mark.
And I failed to dodge. We did it, everybody. 100 deaths.
Let's see if we can get to 500. Let's not.
Fantastic. I'm just getting slaughtered. 101 Dalmatians. Build a macro to do these buffs. Okay. Fell for it. Oh, I was totally dodging. I don't know what happened there. Oh god, this is gonna suck so much. Oh, I've regressed so much.
The rust is so deep. You're not knocking it off, Eddie. We need, like, a fucking... like... sand bath.
The worst part is that if I get some of the rust off today, it'll be then there'll be five more days before I come back. So it'll just form again. We just play Xenoblade Zone Zero.
You're good at that game. You actually played it over the past 2 weeks.
It was the only game I played over vacation.
The only game you could play over vacation, I take it.
Well, you could have played for now. Also, I mean, you could have taken the Switch with him if he has it.
I did take the Switch, I just never played it. Totally dodged. Second phase not activated yet. God damn. There you go. Just creamed. I finally see the second phase and I see nothing else. I just get hit by everything like I was just standing there. I might as well have just stood there. I think we didn't let me dodge. Why? I dodged it. I don't understand. I don't understand why that foot stomp hits every time. Damn. Why even bother? No!
No!
Also, weird question. When did you think? When did you think Echoes of Wisdom was coming out?
I have no idea. I just didn't know it was out when it was out. I feel like farther away, which is weird because I know Nintendo is good about really announcing things close.
Well, it was weird because like when I found out when Echoes was releasing, it was like, oh, that's that's 2 weeks away. When I found out about the release date.
Son of a bitch. Well, they dodged it. And then I get hit by that one instead. Fantastic. I forgot what I was supposed to do there. Nope. 110. I only have 1 hour to have 1 hour. In 1 hour, I will be free of this curse.
March 9th.
It's bad when I'm looking forward to time running out rather than me beating the boss.
Beating the boss.
Oh, didn't grab me. Wait, did I learn any lessons here? Did I learn a lesson? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, I didn't learn a shit.
I learned jack shit.
That should have been the easiest sequence, and I still couldn't do it. I'm doomed. Brennan, I can't wait till I come back with another character and just shield poke you to death. I'm looking forward to that future playthrough.
Shield poke. Elden Ringer. Also, evening, Eric Foxy.
Not too early. Ah, shit. It just stinks knowing that before I went on break, this first phase wasn't so terrible.
It wasn't so bad.
I've regressed. There's no other way around it. It stinks. It stinks so bad. Yeah, I didn't care.
Yep. My Elden Ring strat so far has been unga bunga.
Yeah. It seems like a lot of this DLC has been unga bunga. Or would be solved better with unga bunga. And I'm not an unga bunga build, so I don't get that luxury.
Eddie is not unga bunga enough. He is squish.
Let's see if I can do any good.
I'm so used to dex builds once I wanted to try smashing stuff. Tower shield plus brick on a stick suits me just fine. That's good to hear, Eric Foxy.
Alright, let me see if I learned anything. Nope. 120! We're never going to play Satisfactory. And by extension, we'll never play Sandland. Or the Alan Wake games. We're stuck here. This
or Control.
We're now in a Radon, Consort Radon stream. That's now and forever.
Never will you touch Echoes of Wisdom.
Oh, that don't... I'm not streaming that, so it doesn't matter.
And he's just gonna practice Radon the entire time. And then somehow, due to some psychological effect, every time he gets close to beating him, he just doesn't. He stops. For he is afraid of what he might learn after defeating Radon.
I don't know what life's gonna be after Radon. If I fail on purpose. I still got grabbed. I see it coming.
A 1,000-year voyage guided by compassion.
This grabbed me twice so I can know what that's like.
You're gonna have to survive.
Ermiglio, the Red Prior was giving me similar trouble, but that was just more of my own incompetence. That's Entoria, the last song, by the way. Enotria, sorry.
I'm not sure what the reference is.
Well, Eric Foxy is playing Elden Ring, and I think he was talking about one of the earlier bosses in the primary game. Okay. But since he's doing Unga Bunga, he was having issues, so. Nah, I was talking about this in Enotria, which is a Souls-like that came out recently, and it took a few days to beat. Okay, so he was talking about a different game, but similar situation.
Some bitch. Stop chasing me. Doing so good, and I just let that one attack hit me. Ugh. Ow. We still have half an hour of this. David, I regret you ever got me to play Bloodborne.
Why would you? I mean, we haven't even we finished Bloodborne, didn't we?
Yeah, I know. But if I hadn't played Bloodborne, I would be playing Elden Ring right now.
I'm pretty sure Andy would have gotten you to be playing Dark Souls and Elden Ring with him. And I just finished the final chapter of Jujutsu Kaisen.
Did the ending suck?
No, actually, it's fairly appropriate.
I heard some people complain about it. And like,
people
and
complain about everything.
I didn't trust them. I heard complaints.
Well, I mean, I feel like the ending, the way that it ended, is appropriate for what it is.
Okay.
Admittedly, it's probably not going to be as bad. It's like as bad as let's say Attack on Titan's ending, which he basically stated that like yeah he wrote himself into a corner and that's the only way he could effectively end the series.
Mm-hmm. I should read up what the ending of Attack on Titan is one day.
One day.
Half an hour left. 130.
And goodbye. Yeah, that account was created today. Oh, wow. Ban evasion.
Ban evasion?
We had somebody post one of those stupid links, like, best viewers on da-da-da-da-da. And their account was created yesterday. Since I'm in mod view. It says suspicious user, ban evasion, monitoring. And say are able to publicly post chat messages. N03. That was when I actually. Roughly banned him. So.
I don't know why it refused to dodge every time I pressed the button. Dodge, 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 dodge. Nope, nope, no dodging.
Oh boy.
Seventeen more minutes of torture.
Thank you.
Is there anything I can do that's going to help me survive? Maybe this will help. Let's see if this combination does any good. I'm not gonna make it. Wow, I got hugged again.
He just loves you.
I don't understand why that's so hard to dodge. I can see it coming, and I still can't dodge out of the way. It's the exact same moveset he has before, and it's still...
Still getting ya.
Yeah. The other thing I could try is just one summon.
Instead of lead him off for a little bit. Time, I think, for sleep.
I agree.
Good night, Eric Foxy.
Night, Eric Foxy.
Hope to see you tomorrow.
All of them, son of a bitch.
Oh, burr.
Oh, that's a fruit. I almost thought he got me that time. He's gonna get me eventually. One more, or it's game time. What a nightmare of a stream this was. And that was officially the first Elden Ring boss has taken more than two strings to beat.
I don't think that's true, but then again...
I don't think so. I don't think I've taken more than two strings to beat any other boss, even Millennia.
I was thinking Millennia took about three streams, but...
Well, Elden Ring bosses, yes, but, all I'm thinking is Sekiro bosses.
Yeah, that's different.
I'm only doing Elden Ring. I'm not doing any other Souls-like game.
Yeah, especially since you'd never even got to the final boss in that game, so.
And I think technically, I did two streams and then we never went back to the game, so.
I thought we did at least four.
But the same boss?
We got into a really bad rut on those bosses. Like, the first time, we went at least two to three streams of just fighting the boss.
It's like, I thought we got stuck on Owl. Or was it the first time we fought...
Then we got stuck on Owl. Which then, as far as I can remember, was almost like a month long of no progress.
I remember it being that long.
It was bad.
I mean, it was bad.
I think it was a month long because it's like you had to take a break and this happened again.
Yeah.
Evening, Alec. Might have come in an opportune time.
Oh, I don't know why I went for it.
What's going on? We're watching Baron here. Attempt his third stream of,
second stream. Why are you guys making the things that's already bad worse?
Already worse.
I'm actually trying to remember how it
was. Aw, what?
T-pose.
Okay, this is the last one tonight.
That's why.
And then I'll be free. I'll be free after this, no matter what. Either I win or I lose. Either way, I'm free.
At least for a few days. And really, tomorrow you can join us for my stream.
And be lost on the plot?
Yes.
Yeah, I don't want that. For plot reasons, I can't participate. Jeez. /148. That's how we're ending tonight. 148. Oh. I'm free, though. I'm free until Tuesday that I did this all over again.
How is this? You showed... Admittedly, you could do this on Tuesday and Thursday we resume the multiplayer streams.
But that would be bad because I would accumulate rust.
I feel like what you need to do is do some practice, but I think the only way you can practice legitimately is that you enter and you never heal. Because if you actually can get him down... like consistently to the second half every time without having the need to heal, you probably have a better chance. I don't know if you would keep that up.
I might just have to, yeah, you're right. I might just have to practice fighting him off stream. And
at least that way, your death count is an official.
Although, I would still count it. Well, I would count every death except the one I purposely lose if I think I'm about to beat him, which we haven't even been close. I haven't even gotten to half health yet. After next stream, I might have to consider bringing back another summon just to get this done, and I might have to figure out a strat of how I can beat him with a summon. Because all I need the summon to do is to draw away the enemy. And then I can attack with range, which could work to a degree. We'll see. Okay, well, that's it for today. I'm going to absolve myself of any more of this tonight. So come back Friday, tomorrow, if you want to see Asher do Dragon Questing. And I'll be back Tuesday with more of this onslaught. Bye, everybody.
Mom.